Hi guys, this is Vidas, and today I'm going to show you how to master Allegro Vivace by Louis Vierne from his first symphony in just 9 steps. This is a very exciting scherzo from his first symphony, the fourth movement. And if you follow my tips, steps, and apply in your practice, those will be the steps for you to succeed. Wonderful. The first step is, of course, to stop at every beat. This is Allegro Vivace, very fast tempo. We will not play it very fast. But actually, between the beats, notes can be played as fast as you can. That's the secret to getting up to speed, right? So you just basically start really slowly, play the first beat, think what's ahead, and then play those notes, 16 notes, and then stop on the next beat and think again. Prepare, get ready, play again, stop on the next beat, and so on, every single beat. Let's try. Thank you. So, this was the first step, stopping at every beat. So this is really, really exciting. Slow tempo, but nevertheless it will get faster eventually. The second step is to go back. Once you have mastered the first step, let's say 3 correct repetitions in a row, then you do the second step and stop at the beginning of every measure, on the downbeat. And then stop, prepare, look ahead and play, and then stop at the beginning of every other measure, right? The next measure. Then you do this measure by measure until the end. Let's try. Thank you. So this was the second step, stopping at the beginning of every measure. Now let's go back and do the third step, which is stopping every two measures. This will be a little bit faster. Let's do this. In the second half of this piece, you probably saw one of my lights went off, so the battery sort of disconnected, but I had to plug it in and it works again. Good. So this was the third step, stopping at every two measures. What's happening? Let's see where my battery. Oh, it's empty, I know. All right, we will finish with incomplete light. I will recharge the battery, of course, for later use. Good. So the next step in this adventure is to stop at the beginning of every line. All right, step number 4 would be beginning every line. You stop, you prepare, you look ahead, and then you plan the next line, entire line, and then stop at the beginning of the next line, and so on. Right? Good. Let's do it. Thank you. So this is fun, right? You can already feel what the next step is going to be. The next step is going to be to stop every two lines, all right? And then once you're comfortable, once you can do this step three times in a row without mistakes, you can go stopping at every four lines, which is essentially in this edition one page. Once you can play entire page without stopping, and stopping the next at the next page and the next page until the end of the piece three times in a row without mistakes, then you can do the next step and practice stopping every two pages until the end of the piece. And then the next step is every four pages. And then guess what's the final step? Is to stop at the last basically measure. Don't stop at all, basically, because entire piece is in this edition 8 pages long. So it will take some time, but definitely this is one of the fastest ways to do this, the most efficient ways, because you basically need to only do each step three times in a row without mistakes, and then move on to the next step. And every time you do this, the next day, you a little bit refresh previously mastered material, previously mastered step. And then once you can do this, it will go faster, more fluently, and so on. Right. I really recommend this method. I apply this tip in my practice, so there is no reason for you not to do this too. Okay, guys, this was Vidas. Please subscribe to my channel if you want to get more of my videos. And like this video and comment what would you like me to play next, or leave just a feedback in the comment. I really appreciate it. All right, I guess I'll see you around very soon online with my next video. Bye-bye. Thank you.